the Cloud Gateway Max is easily one of, if not my favorite, Ubiquiti product. But what if we put in SFP 10 gig LAN and WAN ports and gave it PoE? Well, that wouldn't exactly fit, so we'd have to stretch it out a little bit, right? Introducing the all-new Cloud Gateway Fiber, which does exactly that. Ubiquiti took the incredible Cloud Gateway Max, stretched it out a little bit, and gave us, on the back here, SFP ports at 10 gig speeds for LAN and WAN, as well as a 10 gig Ethernet for LAN as well, and four 2.5 gig Ethernet switches, just like normal, and one of them has PoE up to 30 watts. This is a powerhouse, and it's built for some serious speed. Just like its little brother, it runs the full UniFi application suite. It has an NVMe storage slot, which I'll get to in a moment. It has 5 gigabit IPS routing, which puts it ahead of the UDM Pro and SE, and on par with the UDM Pro Max. As I mentioned before, it has both an SFP Plus for LAN and WAN at 10 gigabit speeds, as well as a 10 gigabit Ethernet LAN port. Lastly, going through the back, you've got your barrel jack as well as your reset pin. Internally, we're looking at a quad-core ARM Cortex A73 running at 2.2 gigahertz with 3 gigabytes of RAM. This power combo enables you to manage up to 50 unified devices, as well as 5 protect cameras in 4K, or even more if you wish to drop down to a lower resolution. Lastly, with this powering your network, you can support up to 500 connected clients simultaneously. It does lose a point for not being powered via USB-C, which is one of the things that I love most about the Cloud Gateway Max, but given that it has built-in PoE, I think I'm gonna have to forgive it for that. Comparing this in size, as I did earlier in the video, this is the UCG Fiber, the UniFi Cloud Gateway Fiber, up against the Cloud Gateway Max. You can see that they are roughly if not the exact same height. No, I think that the Fiber is a little bit taller here. And obviously it's a bit wider. And putting them up side by side, you can see the layout comparison of how the ports stack up. I really need to get one of those 10-inch racks that I've seen a bunch of other YouTubers making videos about so that I can show what this would look like if it were in a tiny rack setup for locations that don't need something like my test rack or even my actual proper rack, which is I think it's a 24U here behind me. This would pair nicely on smaller networks that want extremely high speeds but don't want to have everything racked up in a full-size setup like that, where you could pair it nicely with the Flex 2.5 gig, which is capable of all of its switches on 2.5 gig, the Wi-Fi 7 U7 Pro Wall, which obviously has a 2.5 gig port inside, and it is powered by PoE, which you could do with one cable running directly off of the UCG fiber. Additionally, you could pair it with, if you wanted to, the newly announced Express 7, or if you wanted to have fiber going from your cloud fiber, you could have it running to the Flex 2.5 gig 8 port, which has a fiber port on it. Of course, it would help if I took out the little cap, but you could have a fiber cable running directly to the fiber connection on this switch. So you could, in theory, have the Cloud Gateway, and to give you a size comparison, they're basically the same width. But if you had the Cloud Gateway Fiber, and you had a fiber cable going from this through your network, say to a building further away, or a studio setup like I have, a little bit further away, you could have that full 10 gig connection come into the switch, and then have 2.5 gig network straight out of here. And because this is PoE, powered by a local barrel jack adapter, you could do it over PoE, but if you're doing fiber, you are going to need that barrel jack adapter. You could then plug in another U7 access point of your choosing. Now let's pop open the little door. I don't have a drive that came with this one. However, I am going to just pop out the drive from my Cloud Gateway Max. It's the same sled. This is a 512 gig SSD, and I'm just going to plop it right in there. Whoops, it's upside down. No, I'm just going to plop it right in there, just like that. Let's boot it up. All right, I'm gonna get these all racked and set up, and then we'll switch over to the computer view to see what this looks like when it's all set up. Alrighty, now I've come over into the desktop interface. You can see I've got the Cloud Gateway Fiber all set up and adopted. You've got, that was a speed test from before. Let's run another one now and just see what we're getting in the desktop. 19, 2000, 2 gig, which is just about what it should be. 10, 11, 12, okay, upload, download, solid. Upload is sometimes slower, sometimes faster, but should basically be around 2 gig each time I do it. I can do it again in case there's any further variation here. Download is happy. There we go. That's a better upload speed. So it depends on when you do the speed test and multiple factors. All right, now if we look down at UniFi devices, I want to show you a couple of things here. I've got the Cloud Gateway Fiber, which if you jump in here, you'll see the switch layout like normal. You can power cycle directly on the interface, just like anybody who has had experience with UniFi interfaces before. This will look very familiar. Essentially, this is connected right now on a 2.5 gig Ethernet because that's where I plugged it into. You'll see that this is plugged into port 5. The SFP, I want to draw your attention to, is plugged into the USW 2.5 gig 8 PoE, the flex. And then the PoE, the power over Ethernet port here, is plugged into the U7 Pro wall to kind of show off that you can have 10 gig speed, which you see here, SFP plus, directly out from the UCG fiber. And then you can also be powering a access point. So if you want a super fast setup for your small business or your travel kit or whatever it is, this is an excellent way to do it. Now with fiber, obviously that opens up options for doing it much further away. Say you have a distributed setup where you've got a couple of outbuildings on a farm or some other kind of distributed property, such as a large warehouse where you don't need very much in the way of infrastructure, but it is a large space and you'll be able to cover that by putting another switch downstream, utilizing fiber to get there. And then from there, you can broadcast with another access point along the way and so on. So just going through this, you've got obviously the insights. There's not a whole lot going on here because I basically just connected it. You've got your normal stuff over here and locate and restart, and that's on the Cloud Gateway Fiber. And then if we jump over to the Flex 2.5, again, you'll see that it's connected with the SFP port. So that's a 10 gig connection there. And again, very similar. Not a whole lot to show over here if you've used this system before, and the U7 Pro wall as well is connected to the Cloud Gateway Fiber port 4. Everything else in the is going to be, again, familiar and recognizable to anybody who uses Ubiquiti on the regular because it's using their app. One thing I wanted to show also is that you can have, where is our control plane? You can have all sorts of different things installed here. It supports the entire Ubiquiti suite of applications, so Network Protect, Access Talk, etc. I don't have anything else installed other than Protect at the moment, but setup is installed. Access is installed, it's just not set up yet. If we jump over into Protect, you'll see that I don't have any cameras here yet, but that it sees the storage, which actually I pulled from my other UCG Max, the Cloud Gateway Max, and obviously it's not able to see any of that because that is on a different device. Interesting that it didn't ask me to reformat it. That's probably a good idea to do in between swapping memory from one to the other. Oh, interesting. It actually is able to read the drive from the Cloud Gateway Max in the Cloud Gateway Fiber. I didn't realize that was going to happen. That's pretty cool. Set this to high quality. This was from back when I was testing the Cloud Gateway Max and running to see how long it would last on a battery-powered setup. Cute, tiny little small little mini rack, mini network over here.
The Cloud Gateway Fiber costs $249 without any storage included and is available today. If you do make a purchase, I would appreciate it if you used my affiliate link to help support the channel. If you have questions and comments, please feel free to drop them down below. I do my best to read all of them and respond to as many as I can to answer all of your questions or as many as possible. As always, thanks for watching.